Now that we learned about the concept of reproduction, we're going to look specifically at the anatomy and physiology of the human reproductive systems. As we discuss the human reproductive system, we will definitely talk about the differences between the anatomy and physiology of the male and female reproductive systems. But before we do that, first we are going to talk about the similarities. Both sexes in humans have a pair of gonads. These are the organs that produce gametes. These are also the structures that will produce the sex hormones. And these are a paired structure in both males and females, with one on the right side of the body and one on the left side. Also, both sexes have ducts, or tubes, to store and deliver the gametes during copulation or sexual intercourse. And both sexes also have structures to facilitate copulation or sexual intercourse. We're going to move on to a discussion of the anatomy of the female reproductive system. The gonads in females are known as the ovaries. And these are the structures that will produce the egg cell. Within the ovaries, there are these spherical balls of cells known as follicles. Each follicle consists of a single developing egg cell, surrounded by layers of smaller cells that nourish and protect that egg. The follicle is also the source of estrogen, the female sex hormone. So while it's true to say that the ovaries produce estrogen, the follicles are the specific regions within the ovaries that are making that particular hormone. The ovaries are a paired structure, one on the right and one on the left. And ovaries are also internal structures found within the woman's abdominal cavity. Directly adjacent to the ovaries are the oviducts. These are tubes, also known as the fallopian tubes, which carry materials released from the ovary towards the uterus. The uterus is an organ composed of smooth muscle and often described as being pear-shaped, wider at the top, and then it narrows down at the neck of the uterus, known as the cervix. Now, the cervix is the interface between the uterus and the vagina. And the vagina, also known as the birthing canal, is going to be the path which young are born from during a typical vaginal birth. Here we see a side view of the female reproductive system. And here we can see a cross-section of the uterus, how it interfaces with the vagina. One thing to notice that's distinct from the male reproductive system is actually the location of the urethra. The urethra is the connection between the urinary bladder and the exterior of the body. We see in the female reproductive system that this is entirely distinct or not connected to that reproductive system. As we'll see in the male reproductive anatomy, the urethra is shared both with the urinary system and the reproductive system. Ovulation. Is the process by which an egg cell is ejected from the follicle. During a woman's reproductive cycle, one or a few of the egg cells of the oocytes will undergo the process or complete the process of meiosis. And once they are mature, they will be released from the ovary during ovulation. Once ovulated, the egg enters the oviduct, which is a tube lined with cilia, in which those cilia move and beat, sweeping the egg towards the uterus. The uterus is the actual site of pregnancy. As this is where implantation will occur. The cervix is the narrow neck at the bottom of the uterus, and it opens into the vagina or birth canal. During copulation or sexual intercourse, the vagina serves as a repository for sperm. These are the anatomical structures of the female reproductive system. Now we'll look at the anatomical structures of the male reproductive system. There are internal and external components of the male reproductive anatomy. Amongst those external components include the penis, which contains erectile tissue and is used to deposit semen into the female's reproductive tract. Also, the testes, which are the male gonads. So they produce the male gamete, or sperm. They also produce the male sex hormones, including testosterone along with other androgens. The male gonads are external structures. They are contained within a sac of muscle and skin, known as the scrotum. Now, the scrotum has a very specific job, and there's actually a reason why the testes are external structures. Sperm production is optimized at temperatures below core body temperature. And so the job of the scrotum is to regulate the temperature of the testes. It can do this both through its presence of sweat glands and also by contracting or relaxing the muscular component of the scrotum, holding the testes either closer to the core of the body or farther away from the core of the body. Internally, there are several glands which contribute to the formation of the fluid that carries, nourishes, and protects sperm cells. This includes the prostate gland, the seminal vesicles, and the Cowper's gland. The resulting fluid from these glands, including the sperm, is known as semen. Semen is the material released during ejaculation. So here we see a diagram of the male reproductive anatomy. Again, the testes are the male gonads, and they are external structures carried within the scrotum. There's actually a tube leading from each testy, known as the vas deferens, which carry the sperm cells internally into the male's abdominal cavity. In this diagram, it almost looks as if those vas deferens are running directly into the urinary bladder, but as we see from this side view, the vas deferens and the urinary bladder are distinct. The vas deferens meet the seminal vesicles anterior to the prostate gland. If you notice, the prostate gland has a Y-shaped intersection, and it's the prostate gland that actually determines whether the reproductive system or the urinary system has access to the urethra. You can see the urethra here, which runs through the length of the penis, can connect either, again, to the urinary bladder, or also to the rest of the glands of the male reproductive system. Now that we've discussed the reproductive anatomy, let's talk just a bit about the physiology of reproduction. For pregnancy to result, both male and female gametes need to come in contact with each other within the female's reproductive system. And this is the purpose, this is the goal of intercourse or copulation. Sperm produced by the testes will be transported through the vas deferens towards the other glands of the male reproductive system, each of those glands contributing a component to the semen. And that semen will then be ejaculated from the penis. In the female reproductive system, egg cells will mature and be released from the ovaries during ovulation, at which point they enter the oviduct. If copulation or sexual intercourse occurs in the window of time that will allow both sperm and egg to be present within the female reproductive system, it is possible that the sperm cells will travel from the vagina through the cervix into the oviducts. There, if sperm and egg meet and fertilization occurs, that fertilized egg will continue to be transported down the length of the oviducts towards the uterus. Implantation will occur within the lining of the uterus, known as the endometrium, and this marks the onset of pregnancy. In our next video, we'll talk about the process of gamete formation in both males and females. This process is known as gametogenesis. See you in the next video.